Today I'm going to talk about the paper of this microtubule-tuned mechanosensitive cell response. Yeah, they are published by Franchi groups. And the interesting point is that they submit this paper 2019, and then after 2 years of revision, they publish. So very long time. They revised the manuscript, so I could find some part which are highly related to the revision. So for understanding this paper, so briefly I'm going to share about some previous work. So as you know, the high stiffness, when you culture the cell on high stiffness, we already known that focal adhesion, they are strongly mated, and then they are mostly located in the periphery area, surrounding area, not the center. And then actin filament is highly developed. And then you have also nuclear localization. And then because of this, cell area enhanced and migration also fast. But in this paper, they mention about the role of the tubulin. So microtubulin. So the tubulin, so they have some two form, isolation and non-isolation. So let's see in detail about the tubulin. So this is some tubulin structure. So when they normally deacetylate at this K40 area, and then like this. And then when they are isolated, the tubulin structure, they are a little bit loose, and then they can have some gap. And then when they deacetylated, they also closed and condensed. So another way, when you look at in this side, they are very aligned. And then when some force are induced, sometimes this tuber can be cracked, broken. But when they isolated, they are more flexible, and then they are not cracked, they are just shaped. This is a major mechanism why the isolation is important. So again, no isolation, when the force are there, no isolation, this tuber can be broken or departed. But when they isolated, especially the alpha TAT1, it is a well-known tubulin acetylation protein. This alpha TAT1, they acetylate it, and then they are loosening, and then they can resist to some bending force, and they can be also repaired. So acetylation is important to resist the outer force, HRS, for repairing the microtubule. And then, so another paper, see the wild type, when they are touched, their force are there, they are like this. But this TAT is related to the tubulin acetylation. When they mutate the TAT, there is no acetylation, so they are departed, broken. Yes, so where is K40? So I cannot 100% understand the alpha and beta tubulin and then K40, but anyhow, they mention like this. The tubulin consists of alpha and beta, and then from the alpha and beta, alpha, they have some K40 area. So K40 area, they are located in the inside. So this should be isolated. So again, in detail. So also, as you see, affecting and tubulin are linked together by this crosslinker or myosin. Myosin is regulate the affectin, and then affectin microtubule, they are linked by the crosslinker, as well as dianine and kinesin, like this. And then they are motor binding and ectomyosin contractility Michael Tuber should be banded at that time. TAT1 isolation of tubulin protein, they isolated, and then increasing microtubule lattice plasticity and more flexible and resistant to the breakage. So this kind of concept is already known. So again, so heterodimer alpha and beta tubulin, they are form microtubule, and then from alpha TAT and another like protein, they can isolate it, and then more, they are more flexible. And then when they deacetylate the tubulin, also they are using HDAC6 or SIRT2. So this isolation behavior is well known in neuron cell for neuron function like touch sensation or psyllium assembly and stability. Oh, and then this is some recent cell paper regarding the tubulin structure. So alpha and beta domain like this. They have this kind of things, and then this microtubule polymerization. And then this tyrosine is there, and then from this tyrosine is TY. So tyrosine is removed by this VASHI and SVBP, and then they go back to like this structure. So this is microtubule polymerization like this, and then microtubule catastrophe that can be mediated by this tyrosine there or tyrosine removed. So also this tyrosination is also important for regulating microtubule. So this is so I told you about the isolation before. So this is another concept of the microtubule formation or deformation. So this tyrosination is also well known for making the tubal structure and then their catastrophe structure. So in this article also they mention isolation is important for regulating this stiffness dependent cell area change, not by the tyrosination. So that is why I mentioned here.
What does it mean by CCP?
CCP. Maybe this is C-terminal, so I don't know exactly CCP means. But here, somehow some acidic protein, peptide, they are gone or they change it. Sorry about that. 이게 마이크로튜브를 만들 때는 이게 이렇게 돼야 되고 얘를 이제 없앨 때는 이렇게 타이로신을 떼야지만 없앨 수 있대요. 그래서 이제 알파베타 그 모노모노 만들 수 있다고. 그래서 아예 없애냐 아니면 좀 플렉스하게 놔두냐, 이게 이제 플렉스하면 아스틸레이션, 아예 없애면 이제 타이로시네이션을 해야 된다.
그러니까 없앨 때 저 과정이 필요한
거예요? 네, 없앨 때. 마이크로튜브 없앨 때. CCP. Peptidase. Remove the peptide from the C-terminal. Okay, so.
질문
네, 질문.
Acetylation이랑 tyrosination 길이나 assembly, disassembly 관여를 하나요?
아마 길이 관여는 이 tyrosination을 관여를 한대요.
그러니까 뭐. Acetylation은 아니에요.
Acetylation은 그냥 flex하게 똑같은데, 물론 이 좀 플렉스해지면 약간 길이 변화가 있을 수 있을 것 같긴 한데, 그냥 좀 더 느낌이 약간 낭창낭창해진다, 약간 이런 걸 더 많이 좀 강조하더라고요.
길이보다는
유연성을 좀 플렉스를 준다.
저기 나와 있는 그림에 좀 공간이 생기고.
살짝 볼게.
모일 때. 그래서 이제 공간이 생긴다는 거는 이제 혹시나 저렇게 유연해지면서 유인해지면 예를 들어서 이렇게 하면 길이가 여기까지 가려면 필요하잖아요.
그렇죠.
그런 또 자극에서
길이도 길어질 수 있을 것 같아요.
인듀서로 뭐 길이를 조절할 때 관여하는지 궁금해서.
네, 갖다 붙는 거 아니고.
폴리머라이제이션 되는 과정은 티로시네이션이고. 그 저기 앞에 잠깐 보면 H.64하고 SUR2 있잖아요. 이게 그 저기 그 쪽 관련된 그 에피네스 관련된
맞아요.
몰레큘들이잖아.
네, 맞아요.
점점 있는 것 같은데 지금. 우리 지난번에 그 액틴 만들었을 때 H.64
들어갔다가
나오는 그 과정하고 좀 유사한 느낌이 나는 거야.
네, 맞아요.
그래서 혹시 네, 나는 딱 생각할 때 우리 애들 스티프하거나 이런 미케니컬 이걸 큐를 받았을 때 셀이 변형이 되잖아. 여기서도 지금 실험한 셀이 두 가지 아니에요.
휴백이나 아스트로사이트.
휴백. 마이크로튜블이 굉장히 잘 발달한 셀은 유론도 그렇거든. 그 마이크로튜블이 자체가 유론의 그 시그널을 전달하는 트랜스미터, 유론 트랜스미터 전달하는 통로이기 때문에 그 마이크로튜블이 굉장히 중요하다. 우리가 생각할 때 유라 셀들이 스티프니스에서 바뀌는 현상 자체가 그 우리 유클리드 메커니즘하고 에피제네틱스하고 연결시킬 수 있는 그 모레큘이 이 마이크로튜블에는 이거 같아. 그래서 딱 생각이 뭐냐면 우리 그 누구 교수도 그 하잖아, 그렇지?
슈반셀이랑 뭐 아스트로사이트 하죠.
하잖아. 아스트로사이트 하면 스티프한테서 키우든지 뭐 CNT나 이런 나노 테크놀로지 키워가지고 이제 얘가 뭐 잘 되고 안 되고 하는 현상 자체를 조금 에피지네틱스와 연결 한번 해보는 마이크로튜블과 에피지네틱스 연결해보는 그 아이디어를 좀 여기서 얻으면 어떨까 싶습니다.
어, 맞아요. 정확합니다.
딱 나는 이거가 느낌이 너무
신선하죠.
신선한 것 같아서.
또 찾아보니까 이게 아세틸코에이가 아스틸레이션 많이 쓰이잖아요. 그래서 아세틸코에이가 이제 메타볼리즘 돌면서 미토콘드리아에서 나오는 산분이긴 한데 걔도 이제 그 논문도 있긴 하더라고요. 이 버전은 아닌데 그 메타볼리즘 차원에서도 아스틸레이션 이런 거를 해서 뭐 핵을 연다든지 아니면 이런 걸 좀 아스틸레이션 해줄 수 있다.
액틴은 너무 많이 돼서 사실은 생각할 구석이 없어요. 우리도 이 마이크로 튜브를 중심으로 가면 조금 분석을 하면 이 논문 쓰기가 쉬울 것 같아가지고. 근데 마이크로 튜브가 중요한 셀을 써야 돼. 마이크로 튜브가 메이저인 셀. 그리고 지금 마이그레이션 할 때는 또 마이크로튜블이 많이 작동한다 그러니까 셀이 막 움직일 때 마이그레이션 할 때 생각해봐요. 여기 이제 휴백셀 썼잖아, 그치? 휴백셀은 뭐 충분히 관찰하기도 좋고 하는데 우리가 갖고 있고 하는데 한번 그런 거 한번 연구 한번 생각해보라고.
그래서 so For starting this paper, so I'm gonna 누구지? 원서 share one previous paper about. So recently there is one paper regarding astrocyte and Stephanis. So I'm gonna share the paper quickly and then go back to our original paper. Astrocyte MPG Asia. So they also cultured astrocyte on different stiffness. So let's see the result. So they are using arginate gel, collagen arginate gel, as we mentioned before. So using different calcium concentration, they make soft, intermediate, hard, stiff gel. And then they culture the astrocyte. So soft on the right, stiff on the left. So in case of astrocyte, actually, in contrast to other cell, soft gel, astrocyte can spread more. More stiff, they cannot spread that much. In the cell shape also they are more elongated in soft gel, like this. Soft gel, they are elongated. And then also marker of the astrocyte, GFAP, is more highly enhanced in the soft than stiff. And then but they are utilizing other methods like softening using sodium citrate. Sodium citrate, they can uptake the calcium, so they can be soft. When they are soft, they are more, they can show more GFAP and then other, this one beta marker. And then next, when they add more calcium for stiffening, yeah, more spreading area, decreasing cell shape, also more round shape, and then one beta signal is gone. So this paper mentioned about the role of the stiffness, how the astrocyte can be changed. This is a recent paper, 2012 one. And then let's go back to our original paper. So in tubulin, they always stain two things, just normal tubulin and then tubulin acetylation. So they have two marker, two antibody. So on the soft and stiff, tubulin is used as a normal control. Well, acetyl tubulin, when you look at this, they are more enhanced in high stiffness, in the center area especially. And then when they quantify using four different gel, they are making gel using PAA, 1 to 50 kilopascal, they are increasing over, increasing the acetyl tubulin divided by tubulin ratio over increase of stiffness. And then they check by the Western blood, acetylcholine enhanced here, and the quantification. And then next, as you know, the stiffness and the focal adhesion is very well related. So they are using SRC inhibitor and then FAK inhibitor. So when they block the focal adhesion protein, what will happen to the tubulin? So the tubulin control like this, when they inhibit the SRC and FAK, which is downstream of the focal adhesion signaling, when they are damaged, inhibited on high stiffness area, tubulin, acetylated tubulin is gone, like this. So they said acetyl tubulin and focal adhesion highly link together. And then, so they come up with this alpha TAT1. Alpha TAT1, as I mentioned before, the tubulin acetylation protein. And then they want to know this acetylation TAT1 already previously mentioned, they are highly linked to the microtubule. And then they already checked before, this alpha TAT1 also can be linked to the tallin, one of the focal adhesion protein. So from the IP, they want to investigate alpha TAT1, the protein, can be found in the tallin. So they confirm. When they do IP, tallin is there, and then also alpha TAT1. When they enhance the alpha TAT1 in this cell line, they can see the acetyl tubulin structure. So they can link tallin, alpha TAT1, and acetylation tubulin. They physically link together. And next, GFP. Yeah, this is almost similar manner. And then they checked the, they reduced the tallin, the focal adhesion protein. And then they images the alpha TAT, the acetylation tubulin protein, and then vinculin focal adhesion. In control, they are well co-localized together, but when they inhibit the tallin, alpha TAT1 also diminished, and then vinculin also gone. So they reinforced their data, tallin, alpha TAT1, and acetylated tubulin, they are linked together. And then they check after reducing the tallin, acetylated tubulin signal, they are very diminished, like that. And then next, also people already know that stiffness dependent cell change can be mediated by the YAP. So here they are using one of the YAP inhibitor, Y27. So in presence of a Y27, and then they making this alpha TAT induced cell, the TALEN is gone by the YAP inhibitor. This is already known. And then, so this actually, when they perform this, they are using not astrocyte, maybe hex cell. They are using hex cell and then induce this alpha TAT1, and then they are making more acetylation tubulin structure. In that case, in the presence of YAP inhibitor, TALEN is gone. So they want to link the YAP and acetylation tubulin, and then focal adhesion protein TALEN. Y27은 YAP
인히비션 시키는 거예요?
여기서 이제 YAP의 그 상위 시그널을 인히비트해서 YAP으로 그냥 연결시켜주더라고요.
그럼 YAP 인히비터를 써서 YAP을 인히비션 시켰다 이거?
네, 그렇게 표현하더라고요. 아마 서프링가에는 YAP을 쳐가지고 YAP이 좀 떨어지는 거 보여주고 해가지고 VP 같은 거 안 치고 얘는 이걸 쳤더라고요. 예, so here in the same manner, in the presence of low RAC pathway inhibitor to decreasing YAP, this alpha TAT1 is also diminished, and the vinculin also diminished. They confirm it. And then, yeah, also at the same, and here they mention that at the same manner, yeah, they confirm this control. Acetylcholine highly expressed in the presence of this inhibitor, they are gone, confirmed by this image. Okay, and then now they want to check the real relationship between the YAP and alpha tubulin structure, acetylation tubulin. So here, compared to soft, high, they show more YAP nucleocalization. And then when they down the alpha TAT1 for deacetylation of tubulin, the YAP nucleocalization is a little bit diminished. Okay? And then this 2B-shin is a boosting of the alpha TAT1, which means more enhancing the acetylation tubulin. When they enhance, they are more transnuclear localized. In case of soft, also little dim but more localized in nucleus. And then they check the other Hubeck cell, not only astrocyte, so microtuber abundant cell Hubeck, they also show more nuclear localized of YAP in the presence of the alpha tubulin enhancer. This is their quantification. Stiff, go up, knock down the TAT1, go down, and then enhancing the acetylation, increasing, especially soft, and another cell line. And then they want to link this tubulin TALEN. And then in case of, as you know, in case of stiff gel, the TALEN focal adhesion, they are mainly located in periphery area, not the center. On the soft, in contrast, some of them periphery, some of them in the center. So they show like this. And then they quantify depending on the periphery, and then center, and then middle, and then from the middle to center area. So what's the change depending on the stiffness? So focal adhesion density, it's highly decreasing in high stiffness in this center area. This is the center, and then cell periphery is periphery, and then 8 to 16 micrometer is in the between. So only they can obviously see the difference of the focal adhesion in the center area like this. And then next one, they knock down the TAT1. And then boosting them. So in the stiff, they are mainly peripheral area, but peripheral area, but in the presence of inhibitor, not inhibitor, knock down the TAT1, focal adhesion is gone, and also in the same manner, but in case of accelerator of the acetylation, in case of soft, more look focal adhesion more localized in peripheral area than the soft. So like this, the quantification. TAT1, the focal adhesion density in the, this is maybe they measure the center area. Center area, they are more located in TAT1 knockdown. And then when they boost the acetylation of tubulin by tubicin on the soft, they are more located in peripheral area. So center focal adhesion density, they are decreasing. So in summary, they mentioned like that, in stiff substrate, control like that, and then even the acetylation, more acetylation of microtubulin, same manner, but knock down the alpha TAT, less acetylation, the periphery as well as central area focal adhesion, you can see. On the soft, control cell, when they boost the acetylation of microtubulin, this central area of focal adhesion is gone, and then they are more majorly located in peripheral area. And then in that case, nuclear YAP also involved. So YAP inside, they are gone, and then they are more enhanced. So not only the actin, when they change the microtubule acetylation, deacetylation, the YAP can be regulated. And then next, they want to know the cell migration. So here, so normal structure, actin, paxlin, and PMLC. PMLC is actin contraction marker, the phospho-MLC. When phospho-MLC is highly located, they are more induced more power to migrate. So actin is more like that. Paxlin more peripheral, PMLC. Actually, this figure 3 study is done by on TCP, not the gel. And then when they knock down the alpha TAT1, like this peripheral actin is gone, right? And then paxlin also not the peripheral area. They are more located in center area. In the PMLC, they are originally located in the edge, but also they are gone. So here, cell with transverse arc. Transverse arc means this one. When they migrate, not only this axis is also important. So they quantify the transverse arc, how the actin is located like this perpendicular manner. Here, you cannot see any this transverse arc of actin. And then the myosin 2A is similar to the PMLC, also highly expressed in migrating edge area, like this. And acetyl tubulin, they are formed in the center, and it is tubulin. And when they knock down the alpha TAT1, this myosin 2A edge, highly expressed one is gone. Also, acetylation tubulin, they are diminished. And then in case of bimentin is another interfilament component of the cell, and they are also important for migration, cell-cell clustering migration, so like this, but also they knock down the alpha TAT1, their structure also diminish. And then from these SCM images, this is control and alpha TAT1, acetylation decreasing. So here, they can see many microtubule and they're well developed. But in case of alpha TAT knockdown, this microtubule structure, they are very less expressed, not prominent. And then they also check by the HUVEC. HUVEC, in the same manner. Actually, in case of HUVEC, their original acetylation level is very low. So they in the presence of this tubicin, and then they check their morphology. So actin and the vinculin also they look more periphery area and strong. Myosin 2A also you can see more myosin 2A expression in the edge. And then in case of astrocyte, actually they culturing this astrocyte on soft. Previously they culturing on TCP, and here they only using the PAA gel. In case of astrocyte, normal control in the soft gel, actin not well developed, and paxillin also center and periphery. But in the boosting of isolation tubulin, more actin, and then more periphery of focal adhesion. So they prove their concept. Isolation of tubulin can change focal adhesion, migration, and then actin filament structure. And then they check this isolation of microtubulin can regulate the tension of the cell. So they measure the force. So control like this on high stiffness and in the knockdown of the TAT, alpha TAT1, they mention decreasing, using this p-value. Little decreasing here. And then here they induce alpha TAT1 externally. And then they again knock down the TAT1. So when they boosting isolation, they are enhanced of the cell contraction force, and then in the knockdown of the alpha TAT1, they are decreasing. So they reinforce their concept. The cell contraction energy, contraction power can be modulated by the acetylene tubule and microtubule isolation. In case of soft, they are using tubicin to enhance the isolation, enhance the cell contraction power, and then in case of HUVEC, also same manner. And then they check the low A. As you know, low A rock is an important signal for modulating the cell contraction. So when they knock down the alpha TAT1, low A also gone. They confirm. And then, almost finished. So very similarly, they also check this knockdown TAT1, and then also enhanced by isolation by tubicin. So isolation diminished, increasing tubulin similar, and then GFH1 is a low. What is that? Low kinase. This is guanine nuclear exchange factor. So one of the low activation regulator. So already many people mentioned about the role of the GEF when they enhanced. So low activity is enhanced. And then they want to know how the GFH1 is linked to the tubulin. So here, tubulin and GFH1, they are co-localized. Less localized. But in case of alpha TAT knockdown, it looked more localized in microtubule. And then boosting isolation, they are decreasing, which means that when this GEFH1, when they are action, when they act, they have to release from the microtubule. So in alpha TAT1, they are decreasing cell this concept, they are decreasing cell contraction power. So why? This GEFH1 is more attached to the microtubule. And then when they isolation, microtubule is more flexible, and then somehow GEFH1 they are detached, so they are activating low protein, and then they are like that. Now in case of HUVEC, they confirm their phenomenon. As I told you, HUVEC has less isolation level, so they only perform this assay in the presence of isolation boosting factor. In here also control, yeah, they are well localized and well localized in microtubule and TEFH1, but when they oscillate, because of flexibility of microtubule, they are detached, TGFH1 detached from the microtubule. And then this Nocodazole is a similar drug to the tubicin. Nocodazole is well-known microtubule anti-polymerization. They're inhibiting the microtubule polymerization. So this microtubule inhibitor react similar to the acetylation. So in case of Hexcel, also they confirm this similar pattern. And then in case of high stiffness, also TAT1 knockdown, this GEFH1 co-localization is enhanced on the stiff gel. The previous one on the TCP, this is all TCP and HUVEC, and then they are using Hexcel, and then they induce the GFH1, and then they found the law of the relationship between GFH1 and then other acetylene. Here they check on the stiff gel to confirm their phenomenon. And then the last figure, they want to know the cell migration, clustering migration, and they induce the defect using NaOH, like chemical. They drop the one drop on this fully confluent the cell on the gel. They mention the gel structure or gel chemical not change, cannot be changed by this chemical wound. Only the cell are damaged. So on the soft, compared to soft, stiff, they are more migrating. This is well known. Well, when they reduce the acetylation by Si alpha TAT1, this migration speed is diminished. On soft, and on the soft, not that much. In case of stiff gel, they are more diminished. And then this is last their finding. So number one, low substrate rigidity. And then this is a focal adhesion. And then focal adhesion, one of the proteins is tallin there. And then this microtubule and then GFH1, low A activator attached together because they are not acetylated. They are not flexible. And then this GFH1 cannot be detached. And then low A cannot activate it. And then low contractility, because low A is cannot activate them much. And then because of low contractility, low contraction, low traction force, and then migration speed slow. But in case of stiff, many integrin on the high stiffness rigidity, and then in the focal adhesion, more tallin. And then in that case, microtubule, they are more flexed by the acetylation. And then this alpha TAT1, also highly located in microtubule, and then they are detached, and then they are saved. They are localized in this focal adhesion complex. And then GFH1 detached, low A lock activating, high contraction, high traction force, and fast migration. Thank you.